Hi everyone, my name is Roshan Gurung. I'm the co-founder of Sendwin, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use the blur feature. So this is one of the amazing features that we have recently developed, and using blur features you can hide all the sensitive data. You can blur images, you can blur text, you can hide sensitive data. Okay, so this is one of the coolest features that we have developed. Why? Because it not only hides sensitive data, right? It also gives different style to the same sessions, okay? And thirdly, it can share the sessions that is blurred. So let's say you have created a session and you want to share that blurred session to any other members of Sendwin. So you can do that using this blur features. So let me walk through it. So what you can do is you can, using blur features, you can hide sensitive data, blur images and text, okay? So let us see how we can blur any sessions. So I'm going to use Google for it right now, okay? So let me test this out. Okay, so let's say I want to create a session for it. So before, if you try to use it, so if you want to access this, you go, you can access from here. You can see the blurred content. Since this is not the sessions we have created, so we first need to create the session. So if you want to see how to create a session, we have also added a video guide explaining how you can create temporary sessions and stored sessions. So just click, right click and click on blurred content, right? So as I mentioned, you cannot do it right away. You need to first create a session. So let me create one stored session for you. So let me name it Google Blur 2, okay? And blur, this is the category we have created. So you can see that if I go back and try to open this session from here, so let me go back here. You can see Google Blur 2. Let me open this one. So we have created a session right now. Now let's add blur features to this session. Okay. So to do that, right click again and click on blur content. Now you can see that you have this option called blur features, which you can access. So let's say I want to hide this Google image. So what I need to do is I just need to click on the image and that's it, right? So this is your image is hidden right now, and I want to can do the same. If I want to I want to make it more blur, right? What I can do is I can click it here, and I can make it more more blur, right? Yeah, as you can see. Similarly, if I want to clear all, let's say I don't want to like remove all this blur feature, I can click on clear now and all the blurs will be removed. Same way, let me hide this one. Right, so let me go back again and let me first it's data's like sensitive blur features will save all the blur features that you have applied. So let me again go back and click on blur and let me hide this image. I'll make it more blur right now. So this is the way. So let me similarly do this for this one, and you can see this has been blur features has been applied. And similarly, let's say if this session is closed, right, and you say that you want to access this session with the same blur features that we applied, so all you need to do is go to the extension, and here you can see a Google sessions we have created. Click on blur, right? So you can see that all this blur setting that we have added will be automatically applied since we have used blur session for this page. Okay. So this is one of the amazing features that we have. Secondly, let's say I have a different, let me create one more session similar to this one, and okay, Google Blur 3, Blur, let me name it. And let's say I created a new session, right? If you see that this blur features will only work on the applied session. Okay, so if you see in the market, you will find that if you try to blur this page, you need to first use this features. But let's say if you have a multiple Google opened during a live session, right, and you want to hide those sensitive data or account page billing data, images, right, or text, you can do that, right? So this is one Google, and this is the different session we have created. Similarly, what we can do is we can apply a blur session for this. Okay, create, let me first see, let me open this session first. So we have created a blur 3. Let me open this again, and you can see this is different session, right? This is blur 2 session we have created, and this is blur 3. So you can see that the configuration that we added here applies blur to this session only, right? Secondly, this one is good to go. So let me apply a different style here. So I've created this session. Let me hide this one. Let me hide different this one. Let me have this privacy term setting. Okay, you can see that all this data's blur setting has been saved for this sessions. So let me try to open both session, and we can do that. Okay, so if you click on the three dot, you can see open all sites. So all the sessions that we created in google.com will open in one click. So let me open this. Okay, you can see both uses different style of blur activity, right? So first one, blur 3 is hiding a different sensitive data. Blur features 1, 2 is using a different style. Okay, so this was amazing features that we have created using blur to the session. Okay, so we have learned that you can apply blur session blur to any sessions that you've created in Zenvin. Secondly, you can add multiple ways, right, to the same site, and you can open that with just one click. Thirdly, blur session share. So this is one of the amazing features that our developer has been working around, and using this you can share this blur session. So let me go ahead and let me show you. So this is one of the account that I'm having right now. This is test@send.win, right? So let's say I have a member in Zenvin database, and I want to share that user with this blur features applied to this session, right? So you can do that too. So how to do that? So I have created, I will go back and I will see that this is my different account right now. So I'm going to share the previous account where I've created a session, and I'm going to share this session with my second user, right? So let me go ahead and create one account. So test, name it 4, 5, okay, and create, let me apply the password and let me register it. So I'm going to share to this freshly created free account, okay? And if I go to this and let me grab his email, so you can see that this is a fresh account we have created, and it has no sessions right now. So we are going to share a blurred session that we created in previous tab. So let me grab this. go up back again and let me copy this one and let me go back. So we are going to share this first one to show that you can share this session with. So I'm going to apply to this account. So you can see the setting pages right here. All this pages has been hidden. So if I click here and I click on share, okay, the session has been shared. Now let me go back again and let me open this account and let me accept this session shared by my previous account. And if you see that, you can see this Google blur too, right? So irrespective of how many sessions that you create, you can share to any number of users if you're a member of Pro or Pro Plus. Okay, and click on this. So you can see that this is my different account. So this will even work for different PCs if I have, okay.